Our last question for today is, what are some ways to get financial aid for college? Number one, fill out the FAFSA. Don't say, oh, we don't make enough money or we make too much money or whatever. Fill out the FAFSA no matter what. There could be money that you get for the randomest things, and you want to make sure that you get it. Also, a lot of colleges will use the FAFSA to decide what they give you as far as aid, and you want their money that they're going to give you.
Because you're giving
straight
them money.
Yeah, and if they're going to give you money, then you don't want to have to give them money because you didn't fill out your FAFSA. So fill it out ASAP. It opens on October 1st. Do it. I had a friend who is going back to school, and she's talking to me in November, and she's like, oh, I'm so mad. I have to apply for this, and my dad needs to give us financial information because I don't count as an adult student. And I'm like, yeah, you do. She's like, no, I don't, because I have to apply for this year. And I'm like, no, you have to apply for next year because it opens in October. And she's like, oh. So she didn't apply for the FAFSA, and she's not going to school for another year because she would definitely get a lot of grant money that she is going to lose out on now because she didn't apply. So fill it out ASAP. It's first come, first serve. You can get a lot of grants for all sorts of different things. Fill out the FAFSA. Colleges will give you money for merit, for talent, for athletics, in differing ranges. You don't always get the full boat.
You can get it for your family background.
Yeah.
Like,
that's true.
I potentially could have applied for it. Could have gotten it for being, well, one, being the first generation of my family to go to a 4-year school.
Lots of money for that.
Also, because I'm Hispanic, you couldn't tell. My last name's Hernandez. But, I was eligible for some. Didn't go to that school, so that was stupid of me.
I could have gotten a scholarship for being left-handed. I didn't go to that
what?
School.
What?
Yes! One school does
that's,
it.
That's, okay.
I think it's
I could have gotten it, but...
Juanita, Junita. It's somewhere in Tennessee, I believe.
Didn't know.
It's on CollegeXpress. Weird scholarship list.
Didn't know that's
yep.
a thing.
There's one school that gives
Wish
you...
Wish I had
yep.
known that.
I didn't know you were left-handed.
I am left-handed.
Two lefties in the room.
Oh. What up?
That's really so good.
So it's over, but not. Go away.
Yeah, mine was I could have gone to Central Connecticut State with first-year generation being Hispanic, and it ended up being the same cost as Westfield without anything. And my mom was like, you should just apply and find out how much they're willing to give you because of this offer that
yep.
they're already telling you you're eligible
yep.
for. Didn't do it. Went to Westfield. Tons of debt now. And I regret it every day in my life that
yep.
I did it spitefully against my mom to not even try it.
Yeah. Also, make sure you check for scholarships you have to apply to through the college that's separate from the application.
Yeah.
And see if you need to fill out the CSS profile, because some schools will require that. It's a different profile than the FAFSA, but they pull similar information, but the like college looks at it differently.
Does not stand for cascading style sheets.
It's just not different CSS.
Yes.
I have also gotten that confused.
When I read it the first time, I was like, whoop. What is this?
Wrong.
This is sheets with a Z.
Sheets. C-Z-Z.
I got two $2,000 scholarships from different colleges that I applied to because I applied early action. That's not the one that's binding. It's the one that you get to go to other schools and they're like, apply early action, and you automatically get $2,000. I'm like, hello. It is I.
It's
early. Give me money.
I think also when you're looking for money, like most people will just go straight to Google and be like, give me money, find me scholarships.
Yep.
I think the best place to look is like either ask your guidance counselor or go to your community.
Guidance counselor is huge.
Because they're
yep.
not as
yeah.
competitive when they're within your community.
Yep.
Like, yeah, you have the people like in your town. If they, yep. they have a lot of town scholarships, but it's not as big as, you know, the internet. And also, I had a part-time job at Market Basket, and they gave every employee who just filled out a form a scholarship.
Yep.
You just have to know about the scholarship, and then let them know you want a form and fill it out. And it's like a good amount of money that they'd
yep.
give you. So it's just kind of knowing, like, asking around, asking other people who've been to college and filled out scholarships, and then asking people in your town, like, what's available, what kind of scholarships can I apply for?
There may also be grants that you can apply for, which is also free money. We call it free money because you don't have to pay back. And you fill out the FAFSA so that you can get that through the federal government and through the state government. But there are also, like, nonprofit agencies that do it, too. Also look into state programs. I'm working on an article for you guys. You're welcome. Because certain states will waive tuition for college students. So Massachusetts has the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, where if you get a certain grade on, I think it's, like, you get the advanced and then the proficient and a couple of different subjects for the MCAS, then you get free tuition. That does not include fees and room and board, but tuition is like $5,000, $7,000 that you no longer have to pay back. So there's that going for you. It could like have the amount that you have to pay the college. All about it.
So sneaky one that's not an obvious one, but applying to be an RA once you're in college, which Kara's done. Depending on what school you're going to.
Saves you $5,000 a year at least.
Yeah, as you mentioned, yeah, getting tuition waived, but at the same time, if you become an RA, depending on what school you're going to, it could be room and board, which is huge. So it's something you don't really think about, especially if you're commuting, which you didn't end up doing, but at the same time, if you became an RA, you could be saving that amount of money every single semester that you are an RA. Well, technically getting paid for it, too, depending on what school you're going to.
Some pay you while giving you free room and board. Some will just pay you, not give you the free room and board. Some give you nothing. I'm just kidding.
Like I said, make sure you ask what you get then.
Yeah, at Champlain, we got free room. We still had to pay for food, but we also got a certain amount for a stipend per semester. So we got a certain amount per semester, and it was like paid piecemeal throughout the semester, which is great. Work studies, also an option, if you can get that through the FAFSA.
Also, something to consider, which I was able to find easily because I knew I wanted to look at places close to me, you can get, if you're not in state, if you want to get right over the border, some places offer a proximity rate. So, like, obviously, out of state is usually far more than in state, but, for instance, I lived so close to the border of Massachusetts, and I went to Massachusetts State College or University, so I was only, I could have been out of state, but I knew that I got proximity rate, which was only $1,000 more than in-state, because I lived so close. And I think there's one that's New England proximity rate, so that's one that I think most New England states
I think
do.
Most regions in the U.S. have a regional,
like, regional
program.
One,
some of them you have to, like, if you're going to an out-of-state school, it has to have a program that is not available in your state for you to get the in-state rate.
Right.
But there are a bunch of different options with that, too. I mean, if you wanted to take a gap year and work in the state where the school you're going to is, then you could get the in-state school, paying taxes there for a year and having a permanent residence there. Mm-hmm. Just a suggestion.
Almost did that when I went to Georgia.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, that saved me so much because I was like, oh, cool, I could have gone to my state's university versus, which actually then Westfield State with my proximity rate was the same amount as Central Connecticut for me for being in state. So it ended up being comparable, and that's why I was able to choose between the two so easily. But, yeah, that's something to consider for sure.
So I found out last year after I graduated that if I had gone to school in Canada, I would have gotten a huge discount on my tuition because my mom is Canadian. And they told me this while I was crossing the border. Like, at the border, they're doing the whole check of the car and checking our passports. And they're like, are you going to school? I'm like, I just graduated. She's like, you should have gone to a school in Canada. Really, really good rate. I'm like, good to know now that I'm done. Maybe grad school.
Don't underestimate the international experience because you can, A, get a lot of scholarships, and B, a lot of schools internationally are cheaper.
And Canada's awesome.
Canada's great.
19.
Poutine. Go Go Moose. Montreal.
Moose.
Moose.
Maple syrup.
What's the name of the bridge that you get on and you can't turn around?
I don't know.
You know what I'm talking about?
No, you should talk to your brother about that one.
Yeah, because this is a great story with my brother-in-law and his best friend who is from China. And so the two of them were just exploring Vermont, and they ended up on that one-way street going to Canada, and they couldn't turn around. He's on a student visa, and so they got to the border, and they were like, get out of the car. He was stuck there for I don't know how many hours, but they were able to, like, get him and turn around, and he's staying in the state and get deported.
Yeah.
But, so, yeah, just heads up.
Be careful when you're traveling internationally.
Borders.
I think also, again, life regrets. my parents are divorced, and so I probably could have been on either of theirs if I really wanted to. I don't know if this is sketchy or not, but it's fine.
It depends on the state, and I don't know what you're gonna say.
No, I immediately was like, I'm gonna put my, like, I live with my mom, and I mean, my parents have joint custody, but I live with my mom, so automatically, first thought, doing my FAFSA, yeah, absolutely, do my mom. Definitely could have gotten more aid if I had gone with my dad. Some hindsight, think about it when you're actually filling that out. Because I know friends that were in the same financial bracket as my dad, and they got paid to go to school. The school paid them after their 4 years because they needed that much aid. And I was like, could have been me. Yep. But no, I have thousands of dollars of debt because I went with my mother.
If
so.
Your parents have a 50-50 custody, have the one who makes less fill out the FAFSA.
And
you
I
didn't
was,
hear that from us.
But like,
except I think we have like three articles that say
that. I'm a first generation in my family, like I said, and we just didn't know what we were doing at the time. Like, this makes sense. Like, all my mail comes here. So we wanted the bills to go there. If we just owned my dad, we wouldn't have even had the bills.
Yeah.
So think about it.
Also, if you bring up the fact that you're first generation, there are tons of scholarship for that.
We said that.
So,
regrets. A lot of regrets.
Also, student loans are an option. They're not my favorite option. Like Christina, I have tons of debt. No regrets. Oh no, I got Navion. I got the U.S. government coming at me.
Got that MIFA.
Yep.
Massachusetts.
Just got my email saying your money's coming out, and I'm like, thank you for that. They're an option, like not your favorite option, but they're a thing to do if you really want this college. It is an investment in yourself. Also, according to Forbes, one of the things on the rise right now as far as benefits is college loan repayment plans. So, when you're looking for jobs as you're exiting college with your ton of debt, then look to see what benefits they offer, such as college loan repayment. You may have to stick with the company for a few years, but it's worth it, for the most part. Mm-hmm. I feel like even if I hated a job and they were like, we're going to pay off all your student loan, I'd be like, okay.
I'll be here
forever.
I'll make it work. I might be crying in the bathroom, but I can go shopping after
if
I have money.
Just listen to jazz.
Sit there with listening to jazz, eating my microwaved ice cream all day. It's fine.
At your desk.
At my desk.
You're doing
fine. But at least I don't have loans.
Yeah. This is not the situation they're in right now.
No. I love my job.
No.
I love my job. Very happy to be here.
No,
like, very happy that I'm here. Do not eat my
just, like,
ice cream
really trying to, like, say how crazy they're going here. No.
No,
like,
that's
fine.
Fine. No, I love this job. I drive an hour a day to get to this job. It's fine. There's options for you, even if you do have student loans. Plus, we were just talking about student loan refinancing. So
when you do have to take out the loans and you're hopefully not crying and going insane, you can refinance later and make it easier.
Yep, or you can consolidate to the federal government if you have loans where they're, like, similar. And this is, you only really want to do this if they're similar in the amount of percentage of interest. Because if you go to the federal government and you go, I want to consolidate my loans, it will pull all of your loans into one lump sum with one interest rate, and that interest rate is the mean, the average of all of the loans that you took. So if you have like a 7% loan and a 2% loan, don't consolidate. Pay off the 7% loan and then consolidate what's left if you can. Just because that would like raise your interest rate from the 2%. You want to keep it as low as possible.
You're a helpful person to have around.
I've done so much research on this.
We sit and listen to jazz and eat microwave ice cream. We look up how to refinance our loans.
No, it's great. So one thing that's great about this job.
Importing life skills. Microwave ice cream.
What's great about this job, on top of many things, is that part of being an editor here is that I write stuff for College Express. You'll see my name on some things on College Express. And I research for those articles. So if I'm like, I feel like this is a really good topic for students, I will go and research it and get that knowledge and repeat it here and then put it in an article for you.
And then do it for yourself.
And then do it for myself. It's like, oh.
She is just the advice lady. There should be like a column on College Express with Kara. Like, ask Kara.